Chapter 1 Revision. Read aloud. A. A for ant. B. B for ball. C. C for car. D. D for drum. E. E for eagle. F. F for fish. G. G for girl. H. H for horse. I. I for ink pot. J. J for jar. K. K for kettle. L. L for lamb. M. M for mat. N. N for nib. O. O for orange. P. P for pot. Q. Q for quail. R. R for rabbit. S. S for sparrow. T. T for tiger. U. U for urn. P. V for van. W. W for wall. X. X for x-ray. Y. Y for yo-yo. Z. Z for zip. Chapter 2. How to use A and N. The A and N are two indefinite articles. There are 26 alphabets in English language. A is used before the naming words which start with A consonant. There are 21 consonants. These are B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, and Z. N is used before the naming words which start with a vowel. There are 5 vowels in English alphabet. They are A, E, I, O, and U. Use of A. A pencil. A fan. A sun. A kite. A lion. A dog. A ball. A cat. A mango. A nose. A van. A hen. A fish. A parrot. A glass. Use of an. An umbrella. An orange. An elephant. An eagle. An owl. An apple. An egg. An octopus. An ice cream. Exercise. A. Fill in the blanks with A or an. Montu has an umbrella and a raincoat in hand. C. Write the names of the pictures you see using articles A and an. You will get 1 mark for each correct answer. Let us see how much you score. D. Match the following pictures in such a way that the name of each picture starts with the same letter. E. Use the cord to color the picture. Teacher's Corner. Explain the students about the use of articles A and an by giving some more examples. Chapter 3.
Phonic sound of A.
Bat, dad, lad, mad, fat, hat, can, pan, man. Learning skills. An, at, app, air, can, fan, man, pan, ran, van, bat, fat, mat, bat, rat, sat, cap, gap, map, nap, rap, tap, car, far, jar, par, tar, var. Exercise. A. See the scene and fill in the blocks with missing vowels. B. Look at the pictures and complete the sentences. Teacher's Corner. Read the words with A sounds. Ask the students to repeat them. Chapter 4. Phonic sound of E. Hen, yen, den. Wet, net, pet. Bed, red, wet. Learning skills. Ed, egg, en, et, bed, fed, led, red, ran, shed, beg, cleg, dreg, keg, rat, peg, den, men, then, rap, yen, get, jet, let, met, net, wet. Exercise. A. See the scene and fill in the blocks with missing vowels. B. Look at the pictures and complete the sentences. Teacher's Corner. Read the words E sound. Ask the students to repeat them. Chapter 5. Phonic sound of I. Lip, zip, zip. Hill, mill, bill. Tin, bin, pin. Learning skills. In, ip, it, ill. Bin, chin, pin, skin. Thin, clip, drip, lip, ship, skip, tip. Hit, knit, lit, pit, sit, skit. Fill, drill, gill, hill, kill, mill. Exercise. A. See the scene and fill in the blocks with missing vowels. B. Look at the pictures and complete the sentences. Teacher's Corner. Write some words I sound on the blackboard. Ask the students to repeat the words. Chapter 6. Phonic sound of O. Dog, hot, log, rod, cot, mop, god, pot, box. Learning skills. Odd, og, op, odd, god, mod, nod, pod, rod, sod, blog, clog, dog, frog, dog, mop, flop, hop, mop, top, shop, stop, pot, blot, cot, flot, got, trot. Exercise A. Look at the pictures and fill in the blocks with missing vowels. B. Look at the pictures and complete the sentences. Teacher's Corner. Ask the students to read some words with O sound. Chapter 7. Phonic sound of U. Duck, pluck, truck, run, bun, sun, rug, bug, jug. Learning skills. Ug, un, up, ump, dug, hug, jug, mug, rug, plug, bun, fun, gun, nun, sun, run, duck, huck, luck, muck, pluck, truck, clump, dump, hum, jump, lump, trump. Exercise A. Look at the pictures and fill in the blocks with missing vowel U. B. See the pictures and complete the sentences. Teacher's Corner. Write some words with U sound on the blackboard, then ask the students to read them. Chapter 8. Mixed Vowels. See the scene and fill in the blocks with missing vowels. 1. The girl is playing with a doll. 2. A man is watering the plants. 3. Children love ice cream and chocolates. 4. Children are enjoying with the Joker. 5. Buffalo is giving milk. 6. Boys love to play cricket. 7. I go to school every morning. 8. The sun rises in the east. Chapter 9. Singular and plural. When a noun refers to only one, it is said to be in singular. When a noun refers to more than one, it is said to be in plural. One cat, three cats. One boy, two boys. One ball, four balls. One hen, four hens. One goat, four goats. One pencil, five pencils. One chair, four chairs. One owl, four owls. One book, three books. One top, five tops. Exercise. Fill in the blanks with plurals. Teacher's Corner. Explain the meaning of singular and plural. Use real objects to practice. Chapter 10. Uses of this and that. This is used to indicate the object which is near. That is used to indicate the object which is far. Read and understand. This is my car. That is a clever man. This is my bike. That is a metro train. This is my pet dog. That is a wild animal. Exercise. Use this or that and complete the given sentences. Teacher's Corner. Explain the students where we use this and that. Chapter 11. Use of these and those. These is used to indicate the things or objects which are near. Those is used to indicate the things or objects which are far. Read and understand. These are tigers. Those are foxes.
These are players.
Those are boys. These are goats. Those are cows. Exercise. Fill these or those to complete the sentences. Teacher's Corner. Take some examples from the class itself to teach the students the concept of these and those. Chapter 12. Use of what? What is used to ask a question? What are those? Those are elephants. What are these? These are mobile phones. What is this? This is my car. What is that? That is an aeroplane. What is this? This is my book. What are these? These are flowers. Exercise. Fill what and complete the given sentences. Teacher's Corner. Teach the students how we use what by giving some more examples. Chapter 13. Gender. Gender is of two types, one masculine and two feminine. King, queen. Lion, lioness. Boy, girl. Cock, hen. Father, mother. Dog, bitch. Brother, sister. Tiger, tigress. Grandfather, grandmother. Peacock, peahen. Exercise. A. Match these pictures with their opposite gender. B. Write the opposite gender of the following. Teacher's Corner. Explain the concept of gender to the students with examples. Chapter 14. Use of I, my, you and your. 1. I am Kamla. This is my doll. 2. You are Surekha. This is your lunchbox. 3. I am Ravi. This is my bat. 4. You are Sudha. This is your ice cream. 5. I am Preet. This is my pet. 6. You are Renu. This is your house. 7. I am Aman. This is my orange. 8. You are Rohan. This is your football. 9. I am Ishan. This is my father. 10. You are Annie. This is your gift. 11. I am Aparna. This is my child. 12. You are Raman. This is your guitar. Exercise. Fill in the blanks with I, you, my, and your. Teacher's Corner. Explain the students where we use I, my, you, and your with the help of simple sentences.
Chapter 15.
Use of he, his, she, and her. He and his are used for male. She and her are used for female. 1. She is Rita. This is her doll. 2. He is Ram. She is his mother. 3. He is my brother. That is his bag. 4. She is Suman. This is her comb. 5. She is Renu. He is her brother. 6. He is Javed. This is his kite. 7. She is Reena. That is her frog. 8. She is my mother. This is her purse. 9. He is my grandfather. That is his stick. 10. He is Ram. He is his brother. 11. She is Ritu. That is her gift. 12. He is Harjinder. This is his gun. Exercise. Tick the correct word. He, she, his, or her. Teacher's Corner. Explain the students where we use he, she, his, and her with the help of simple sentences. Chapter 16. Use of we and they. I am Daisy. You are Rosie. We are good friends. I am Rahul. You are Nitesh. We are singers. She is Navya. She is Beena. They are sisters. He is Rohit. He is John. They are neighbors. Exercise. Look at the picture and fill in the blanks with we and they. Teacher's Corner. Tell the students where we use we and they by giving them some more examples. Chapter 17. Use of prepositions. Prepositions are used to show the location or position of an object. 1. The stars are shining in the sky. 2. The cow is in the shed. 3. The books are on the table. 4. A pen is on the books. 5. A rat is sitting under a table. 6. A man is under a tree. 7. The tortoise is behind the rabbit. 8. The girl is behind the table. 9. The girl stood between the trucks. 10. The girl is standing between the boys. 11. Rajat is standing near his father. 12. The cub is near the lion. Exercise. Fill in the blanks with near, on, behind, between, at, or in. Teacher's Corner. Explain the concept of prepositions to the students. Chapter 18. Use of was and were. Was is used in past with singular subjects, that is, I, he, she, and it. Were is used in past with plural subjects, i.e., you, they, and we. He was playing. You were working. They were studying. She was running. It was raining. They were eating. Exercise. See the pictures and fill in the blanks with was or were. Teacher's Corner. Explain the students that was is used with singular subjects and were is used with plural subjects. Chapter 19. Use of had and have. Has is used with singular subjects except I, that is, he, she, and it. Have is used with plural subjects, i.e., they, we, and you. Have is also used with I. She has a mic. I have apples. She has balloons. You have a doll. He has an orange. They have toys. She has a hat. We have books. She has two pencils. I have a key. Exercise. See the pictures and fill in the blanks with has or have. Teacher's Corner. Tell the students where we use has and have by giving them some more examples. Chapter 20. Qualities. This is a boy. He is short. He is a short boy. This is a man. He is fat. He is a fat man. This is a camel. It is tall. It is a tall camel. This is a bunch of grapes. Grapes are green. These are green grapes. This is a lion. It is big. It is a big lion. This is a child. It is small. It is a small child. Exercise. 1. Circle the qualities in the following sentences. 2. Choose the correct qualities to fill in the blanks. Teacher's Corner. Ask the children what qualities do they have. Chapter 21. Yes or no type questions. Is this a goat? Yes, this is a goat. Is this a parrot? No, this is a peacock. Is this an owl? Yes, this is an owl. Is this a raincoat? No, this is an umbrella. Is this a girl? Yes, this is a girl. Is this a snake? No, this is a rock. Is this a giraffe? Yes, this is a giraffe. Is this a dog?
No, this is a rabbit.
Is this an elephant?
Yes, this is an elephant.
Is this a boat?
No, this is a car.
Is this a violin?
Yes, this is a violin.
Is this a tube light?
No, this is a bulb.
Exercise. See the pictures and write the answer with yes or no. Teacher's Corner. Ask the students some questions that can be answered in just yes or no. Chapter 22. 7 days of a week. A week has 7 days. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. First day of the week is Sunday. Second day of the week is Monday. Third day of the week is Tuesday. Fourth day of the week is Wednesday. Fifth day of the week is Thursday. Sixth day of the week is Friday. Seventh day of the week is Saturday. Which day is the last day of the week?
Saturday.
Which day is the holiday of the week?
Sunday.
Which day comes between Monday and Wednesday?
Tuesday.
Chapter 23. 12 months in a year. There are 12 months in a year. January. January is the month of snow. Temperature of the season is low. February. February brings love. The lady feels like a dove. March. March is the month of colors. Everywhere dancing daffodils and flowers. April. April showers brings flowers sweet. Scatter nature at our feet. May. Lovely is the month of May. Everyone feels happy and gay. June. June brings lilies and roses. The hands of children fill with posies. July. Cool showers of 4th July make people feel energetic and high. August. August is the month of harvest when the sheaves of the corn are pressed. September. September is warm and fruity, makes men playful and sporty. October. October is the 10th month of the year. It makes people great and cheer. November. November is dull and blast. It precedes the year to the last. December. Christmas tree and carols in December. It leaves fond memories to remember. Chapter 24. The Foolish Ass. Story time. The Foolish Ass. A merchant had an ass. He cared for it very much. He gave it grass and hay to eat. He went to city Delhi with a bag of salt. His ass carried his bag. One day, the ass slipped and fell into the water with the bag. Some salt got washed away with the water. The bag became light. The ass felt very happy. Now, it daily fell into the water purposely and made the load light. The master was very angry and annoyed. One day, he loaded the ass
with a bag of cotton instead of salt. The ass fell into the water, but this time the load became heavier. The master beat the ass to move it forward. The foolish ass repented. After that, it never played tricks. Moral of the story: we should not shy away from work. Chapter 25. Action words. Action words are verbs that specifically describe what the subject of the sentence is doing. Read aloud. Kabir is playing. Divya is dancing. Sunil is singing. Monu is walking. Tinu is running. Ravi is jumping. Rahul is cycling. Chaman is driving. Kapil is eating. Madhu is drinking. Kiran is reading. Karan is writing. Exercise. Write the action word. Teacher's Corner. Explain the concept of action words to the students. Chapter 26. Good Habits. Welcome your guest with a smile. Say excuse me before interrupting a conversation. Knock before you enter a room. Help the needy. Say sorry if you hurt someone by mistake. Share your belongings. Listen carefully. Wash your hands before and after eating the food. Always greet your elders. Exercise 1. Look at the pictures and write the good habits that we should follow. Teacher's Corner. Inculcate good habits in students. Chapter 27. My Class. Conversation. 1. In which class do you study? I study in class 2. 2. How many students are there in your class? There are 50 students in my class. 3. Who is your class teacher? Miss Reema is my class teacher. 4. Who is your class monitor? Shivam is our class monitor. 5. Where does the teacher write in the classroom? The teacher uses a blackboard to write. 6. What does the teacher use to check your copies? Our teacher uses a pen to check our copies. 7. What do you call the other children studying in your class? I call them classmates. 8. Should we make friends to our classmates? Yes, we should all be friends with each other. Teacher's Corner. Tell the students not to fight among themselves. The Thirsty Crow. It was a hot day. A crow was very thirsty. He was in search of water. He flew here and there. At last, he saw a pot of water. He looked into it. There was some water in it. His beak did not reach the water. He thought of a plan. He picked some pebbles and put them into the pot one by one. The water rose up. He drank the water and flew away. Moral of the story: where there is a will, there is a way. Let's enjoy with story. Never tell a lie. Ramu was a shepherd boy. He was very naughty. One day he played a trick. He cried, "Wolf! A wolf!" The villagers ran to save him and his sheep. But there was no wolf. The villagers asked him, "Where is the wolf?" "I didn't say that the wolf was here," said Ramu, and he laughed aloud. The villagers returned to their fields. After a few days, the wolf came. Ramu cried, "A wolf! A wolf!" The men did not bother to even look at Ramu. Before he could find anyone who would believe him, many sheep were killed by the wolf. Moral of the story: a liar's truth is seldom believed. Shepherd, Charvaha. Noti, Nutcut. Wolf, Bhediya. Believe, Vishwas Karna.